Okay, so Mafia 2 at 21x9. So the game only supports 21x9 as basically as it can, but it does so without fuss. The menus and cutscenes and loading screens are all 16x9 with black bars. However, it does mean that there is no stretching or zooming or anything else, which is often too frequently seen on games. At least this way, the game still functions perfectly. Once in game, 21x9 appears, and it is great. The HUD scales to fit the screen without a problem, and it is lovely to see the game in an ultra-wide format. Overall, it's a good game for 21x9. No mods are needed, and everything works, really, as long as the actual gameplay is 21x9 and the menus all work correctly. I don't have much of an issue. So I hope that gives you a new look at Mafia 2. I'll leave the gameplay in the background so you can see more of it in the lovely 21x9. For any of the games at 21x9, head over to my channel. Hopefully I've covered it. If I haven't, then stick a comment down below or inbox me and I'll try and cover it. Have a good day.
Empire Bay.
Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know where Joe Barbaro lives?
To the right of the stairs. And tell him that racket last night has to stop.
Boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B. They made him blow a bugle for his Uncle Sam. It really brought him down because he couldn't jam the cap.
You made enough cash for all this in the last 3 years?
The last
3 months? Holy shit.
You just gotta know the right people, and you're all set, because you know me. So you thought about what you're gonna do now?
You said you were gonna introduce me to that guy Giuseppe. Hey, you think I could,
What? Drive, Vito? The roads are icy. You ain't never drove a car before.
Joe, I was driving almost the whole time I was over there.
Yeah, but this ain't no tank, Vito. This is one of the nicest cars money can buy.
I didn't drive a tank. I drove a Jeep.
What the hell's a Jeep?
It's, Never mind. You're gonna let me drive over.
All right. Here's the keys. Just be fucking careful. All right, when it's cold as fuck outside, you gotta give it a little more gas than usual. That's the pedal over there on the right.
I know, Joe, I know.
Okay, now make a right here. Then just go straight for a while. Hey, whoa. Slow it down a bit. No need to get pulled over for no reason. Hey, Vito, you know what time it is?
It's daytime. How the fuck should I know?
It's time for you to get your own fucking car.
Yeah, I'd love to if I could afford one.
Who says you're gonna pay for it? You know, you wasn't kidding. They really taught you to drive over there. At least something good come out of it. Ooh, get a load of that baby.
Nice, that's a 42 Jefferson.
Beautiful car like that, it'd be a shame to smash the window. You should grab yourself some lockpicks over at Giuseppe's. Welcome to Giuseppe's General Store, a thief's paradise. You name it, he's got it. He even sells phony gun permits and discharge papers for guys tired of getting their asses shot off.
We need a set of lockpicks, too.
That we do. And guess who's paying for them?
Grazie. Well, you can test it right now. Here, take this lock. You just need to insert the pick into the lock and lift all the pins. You use the wrench to hold the pins one by one. Oh, damn it.
See you around, Giuseppe. C'est Benedict.
Easy, huh?
Don't worry. You'll get the hang of it. I do it all the time when I lock my keys in the car. Okay, you still feel like snagging that car?
You kidding me? Absolutely.
Well, here's your chance.
Possible stolen vehicle.
Step on it.
Copy that. Vehicle theft in progress. In pursuit of suspect.
It's not over yet. Lose him. Quick.
Roger that.
Looks like we lost it. So how do you like the car?
Not too bad. Think I'll keep it.
All right, let's go find ourselves a body shop. They provide the kind of services we're looking for.
Hey, that don't sound cheap.
Don't worry about it. I got it covered. Just find any body shop. I know the guy who runs it. Here, park right here in front of the garage door. Okay, now honk your horn.
Hey. How can I help you? No license plate. For you, no problem. There you go. Hey, thanks a lot.
All right, next you should introduce yourself to Mike Bruski. He probably have some work for you.
All right, where is he?
He owns a junkyard over in Riverside. You can't miss it.
Hey, who's that guy back there?
What guy?
The guy at the body shop.
Oh, Tommy. He's my buddy's nephew. He's kind of quiet, but let me tell you, the kid's some hell of a dancer. Saw him at the old dance hall in Oyster Bay a couple of weeks ago. He had all the broads going nuts.
Do I detect a hint of jealousy?
Are you kidding? I don't need no dance moves. I got charm, my friend. Here, I'll give you some of my lines, so maybe you won't have to spend so many nights with Rosie Palm and her five sisters. Hey, here's one. Hey, is that a mirror in your pocket? Because I can see myself in your pants. Now, here, I got another one. If I could rearrange the alphabet, I'd put you and I together.
Oh, come on.
Oh, this one never fails. Hey, baby, that's a nice outfit. It'll look good crumpled up at the foot of my bed in the morning.
And this works for you.
Oh, here's a good one. Hey, do you know the difference between sex and conversation? No? You want to go back to my place and talk?
You got problems, you know that?
How about this one? Why don't we go back to my place and play house? You be the door and I'll slam you.
Oh, that was bad.
Hey, when you measure seven soft, you don't have to be good with words. You get my drift?
In pursuit of a hit-and-run driver. Roger that.
That's Mike's junkyard there. Just drive through the gate.